A lot of super chats came in shortly here. And we're off, guys. How are you doing? So, it is Tuesday, March 22nd, 2022 AD, 9:01 a.m. U.S. Pacific Daylight Time here in Los Angeles. Oh, wow. Indeed. And I have a fun Tuesday show for you. Happy Tuesday, everybody. I'm going to talk about this Ketanji woman. I don't have a lot about her, but I have some about her and about how the RINOs are kissing up, pretending it's so historic. Oh, my gosh. I remember when they were saying that Obama being elected the first black president would be historic. Historic. Dumb. Wrong black president. The worst black president. You don't say so until after the intro, Hake. Wake up. I will also talk about this gay trans agenda. I had a caller yesterday from Los Angeles ask me about Dave Rubin getting a couple of sons. And I have actually some super chats as well about related to that that I did not get to. Super chats from the Hake Report yesterday. And what else? That, oh my gosh. So many other things. And of course, your calls. But anyway, guys, let's get right on with the show!
1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, it's the Hake Report. The Hake Report. La, la, la.
Doing? I am fine. I was just taking a peek over at the JLP Streamlabs, and a lot of super chats came in for JLP towards the end there. We will get to those We will get to those tomorrow. And how are you guys doing? Happy Tuesday, everybody. Tomorrow is Wednesday. Did you catch? Wednesday is exciting for me because we have the Bond Archive Sunday service premieres, which are always excellent. From 2013 is the year that we're on now. Did you catch Nick's stream last night, guys? Nicolas, Nick's stream, N-I-C-K-S-T-R-E-A-M. Yesterday, I call it last night, but it was yesterday, 4 to 6:15 p.m. or something like that. Anchor Baby's new show is called Nick's Stream. Check it out. I know I did. It was getting dark. I mean, the sun was going down, so I had to... Actually, the sun was not going down. But I got out for a walk, so I had it in my earphones, but not too loud, so I could still hear the traffic, because you're not supposed to run with your earphones or walk with your earphones in. But anyway, I am excited about it. It was funny. He covered cartnarks. That's not where the cart goes. sorry, man. You have a high-pitched voice. I'm not talking to Nick, but I'm talking to the cartnarks guy. I said that whites tend to put the carts back more frequently than other races. But there are some whites who do not put the cart back. I think I even might remember a white who littered once. Shameful. But I know many whites who pick up litter freely. And they're not charged with anything. It's not forced community labor or anything like that. They pick it up voluntarily because they're cleaning up their neighborhood. Isn't that nice? Well, let me cover a case of a black who is not, in my opinion, cleaning up the neighborhood. She's bringing mess into the world. This Obama judge, is she an Obama judge? Ketanji. Ketanji Brown Jackson. I found out that she is indeed, and I've covered this before, I think, she is indeed married to a white man. She's black. Born Ketanji Brown Jackson. Brown is her real last, I mean, her maiden last name, but she changed it to her middle name because you know how these females, they like to keep their last name in there somewhere. Kind of like Amy Berman Jackson. I'm not sure about that one. But Amy Berman Jackson is another female judge. She is a Jewish woman or something. And she was married to a black who was an Obama attorney. And she's evil, really evil. She's going after the J6 patriots. But anyway, Ketanji Brown Jackson, I call her Ketanji Jackson. She was born Ketanji, K-E-T-A-N-J-I, Onyika Brown. Terrible. Born in 1970. So she's got like 11 years on me. About 51 years old, something like that. An American attorney and jurist who has served as a federal judge on the United States Court of Appeals for the District of Columbia Circuit, D.C. Is everything related to D.C. corrupt? Ketanji Onyika Jackson? Onyika. O-N-Y-I-K-A. And, born in D.C., raised in Miami, Florida. Attended Harvard. Not good. Not good. And she has a white husband, purportedly white, with a long history in America, like many generations, dating back supposedly before the Mayflower, which was the boat that brought some of the pilgrims in, right? Something like that? Press 1 if you return cards, and I see a whole lot of ones. But press 2 if you put back other stray cards. Wow, some people pressing 2. some people even putting back other stray cards. Wow, good for you guys. Cleaning up the neighborhood. That's nice. But, oh my gosh. She's related to Paul Ryan, by the way. Let me show you some pictures of her with her husband, whose name is Jackson. Patrick Jackson, I believe. And yikes. There he is. With his bow tie. What's a white man doing with a bow tie? Is this Tucker Carlson type of bow tie, or is it kissing up to the blacks bow tie? Because remember when Tucker Carlson used to do that? Because Tucker Carlson was like this DC, like kind of those uppity style DC boys. So is it that? And this man is a surgeon, a medical doctor. Patrick Jackson, man, yikes. Supposedly her first boyfriend, by the way, and now her husband. Been married since like the 90s, I think. To me, it doesn't look right when they do this. I mean, the interracial marriage thing. To each his own, I guess. But to me, just doesn't look right. And especially, this guy has like a long history in America, and he's just squandering that. And she claims, oh, I'm sure I had slaves. I mean, in my ancestors. Oh, is that one of her daughters? Their daughters? There he is with his mask on. Oh my gosh, how embarrassing. With the baby blue surgeon mask looking thing on. I wonder how he finagled it so it doesn't fog up his glasses. If I wear sunglasses over a mask, like my sunglasses are getting fogged up. But he's wearing every picture of him, I'm seeing a bow tie. Practically every picture, at least the official ones. And I say the black thing because a lot of the blacks, including the black Hebrew Israelites, here he is in a white suit or light gray, light blue, baby blue, light blue, and a blue white shirt, brown shoes, looking almost like Colonel Sanders, but not as Chad as Colonel Sanders, not as Alpha as Colonel Sanders, looking like a nerd. And he has a bow tie. This bow tie thing, I am not a fan of. I didn't even like it really with Tucker Carlson. To me, it looks kind of silly. Clarence Thomas has a white wife. Reminds Guido Sanchez reminds me that Tucker Carlson had. I mean, Clarence Thomas has a white wife. I know. I've never seen pictures of them together, though. So it's okay. And she's tough and he's tough. Ketanji, is she not a, is she a Christian? Is Ketanji a Christian? This woman who's appointed to the Supreme Court or nominated to the Supreme Court. They wear a bow tie because the necktie, I think the idea for the blacks is that it looks like a noose or something, or it's related to the noose. So they, it's rebellion against the white man. So lame. Yeah, this woman is 51 years old. Married in 1996 to Patrick Jackson. Two children, two daughters. Daughters, of course. Am I right? Talia and Layla. Good old American white names. Am I right? Not. Doesn't sound like American white names. Because they have, because their mother is Ketanji Onyika Brown. Her parents must have been radicals, right? Not good. What's the idea? What's the idea in your in the 70s naming your daughter Ketanji Onyika? Not good. And I think that she was doing stuff against Trump, by the way. I think I had mentioned that. She had done stuff related, you know, tried to take, and she had some of her rulings overturned. Some of you guys know more of that than, more of that than I do. I think Taking Care of Business knows more than I do about the, about that stuff. About her record as a so-called judge. Not a good person, not good. And she's a liberal. She just is. And she's a black female. So she doesn't have the nicey, nice, girly, soft, gentle, nicey, niceness, go along to get along. What is that word when you want to compromising? She, I don't think she's going to be such the compromiser that Stephen Breyer was, who's this liberal Jewish judge, justice, so-called justice on the Supreme Court, honored by Biden. He was pushed, forced. Even the mainstream media says that there was this campaign to get him to retire while the Democrats are controlling the situation, right? Oh my gosh. And he did, because he's such a kiss-up. And this woman, I don't think that she's a kiss-up. I think that she's a pushy person. Her husband looks weaker than her. Two daughters, Talia and Layla. So I wonder if the husband wanted to name them like Mary, because that's a white name, despite what JLP thinks. And like Marie, something like that. Anyway, Paul Ryan, the RINO Paul Ryan, who is a so-called, remember him? A so-called Tea Party guy. We were all excited about, ooh, Mitt Romney and Paul Ryan. I say we, probably many of you not so much, because you guys knew that they were both bad news. But I voted for Mitt Romney and Paul Ryan, to my shame, right? But I don't know, we had to vote against Obama, right? Mitt Romney, the RINO, Paul Ryan, the RINO, against Obama Biden in 2012. Paul Ryan is related to Ketanji Brown Jackson, according to the Washington Compost. Patrick Jackson. Patrick, that's like an Irish name. And Paul Ryan, I think he's Irish. Are they Irish? I don't know. Paul Ryan said this back in 2012, when Obama had appointed her, I guess. Our politics may differ, but my praise for Ketanji's intellect. I like how he used her first name. Her character, her integrity, it is unequivocal, said Paul Ryan, kissing up at Ketanji Jackson's 2012 hearing for her nomination as the U.S. District Court judge. Last year, she was confirmed to the prestigious D.C. Federal Court of Appeals. She's an amazing person, and I favorably recommend her consideration. Recuse yourself, Paul Ryan. She's in-law, family. You should recuse yourself, Paul Ryan. Total kiss-up RINO. here he is in 2022. I have a tweet from him. Jana and I, that's his wife. I don't know why he's including her. Jana and I are incredibly happy for Ketanji and her entire family, including yourself. Our politics may differ, but my praise for Ketanji's intellect, her character, integrity, unequivocal. He said that again, apparently, or he said that in 2022. Maybe in 2012 he said something different. No, he said it twice. In 10 years. Kiss up. And by the way, on the if you saw that tweet, it's who can reply? Only people Speaker Ryan mentioned can reply. He did not mention anybody. So he banned you from replying to him. Except you can quote tweet him and call him a simp for the blacks and the women. What a shame. So Ketanji Jackson's brother-in-law, Ketanji Onyika Brown Jackson's brother-in-law, is her husband's twin brother, William Jackson, okay? And William Jackson, her husband's twin brother, is married to Paul Ryan's sister-in-law. His wife is Dana, and her sister apparently his wife is Jana, and his sister-in-law is Dana. What a mess, huh? Terrible. Nasty. Okay, so the far-left female run outlet, The Skim. Let me just blow through this last little bit of Ketanji. Ketanji Brown Jackson. Judge Ketanji Brown Jackson, according to the far-left female run outlet, The Skim, said yesterday, the Supreme Court nominee vowed to defend the Constitution. Democrats don't defend the Constitution, they rewrite it. And neither do RINOs, honestly. So whether she was going to be a Democrat or a RINO judge, give me a break. She was going to rule on cases from a neutral posture. Yeah, right. Her remarks followed hours of opening statements from Senate Judiciary Committee. Did you know that former Congressman Steve King on the Judiciary Committee? Somebody look it up and let me know. Congressman Steve King, the great Congressman Steve King, who spoke at AFPAC 2, and he was at AFPAC 3 as well. He was he was smeared by the failing New York slimes, and his own RINO Republican counterparts ousted him, and he was primaried by the RINO RNC. So we all know the Republicans are mostly trash. It's a fact. Mays trying to say, oh, you like them until they do something you disagree with. Then you hate them. And you only hate them because you're told to hate them. That's Maze, black woman. My favorite caller. Democrats praise Ketanji Jackson, including her judicial record and diverse perspective. What are you talking about, diverse perspective? Oh, because she's black and a woman. I guess that's what they mean. Republicans questioned her previous rulings on everything from child porn sentences, whoa, to her time as a public defender. A public defender. Both sides acknowledged the historic moment. See? Lame. Senator, listen to Lindsey Graham. Lindsey Graham got tough when Judge Brett Kavanaugh went through the ringer, right? They said, oh, he's a rapist. Brett Kavanaugh was a potential rapist, credibly accused of rape by that dumb woman, right? And Lindsey Graham's like, oh, I'm so mad right now. But now he's kissing up. He's all, count me in on the idea of making the court more diverse. That's my impression of Senator Lindsey Graham. Maybe I can improve it a little bit, but he talks like this. Something like that. Makes me want to spit. Wanting the court to be more diverse. I would spit if this were not Jesse Lee Peterson's studio. Shout out JLP. Thank you. Now, 2 days of grilling from lawmakers. Grilling. Yeah, right. Ooh. Especially after some Republican senators, they promised to hold their feet to the fire. Yeah, right. Marsha Blackburn lectured the first... This is a headline from Rolling Stone, guys. I just a few headlines. I'll get to calls. You can call in. 888-775-3773. This is a headline from Rolling Stone, which is a music outlet that puts out fake news, like fake Me Too stories, and they had to retract. A rape on campus, Rolling Stone. Marsha Blackburn lectures the first black woman nominated. Marsha Blackburn's a RINO female, right? But she's a Republican, right? So they hate her. Marsha Blackburn lectures the first black woman nominated to the Supreme Court on so-called, and they put that in quotes, white privilege. The Republican from Tennessee, Marsha Blackburn, representative, suggested Ketanji Onyika Jackson, that it's merely a coincidence that only two of America's 114 Supreme Court justices have been black. And they capitalized the B in the word black because they're kissing up. So, you served on the board of a school that teaches kindergartners, five-year-old children, that they can choose their gender, and it teaches them about so-called white privilege. That's what Blackburn said after bashing the radical left. Is that true? Is that true? Was she on the school board? She went so far, Senator Marsha Blackburn, this is by Ryan Bort, purportedly a male reporter for Rolling Stone. Marsha Blackburn, Republican from Tennessee, went so far as to suggest Jackson, a black woman, that white privilege doesn't exist in America. A country where, of the 114 justices to have been confirmed to sit on the highest court in the land, only two have been black. Wow, so this woman's on a school board that teaches kindergartners, five-year-old children, they can choose their gender, and that teaches them about so-called white privilege? Right on, Marsha Blackburn. Why does it have to be the females who act, who pretend like they act a little bit tough, and the males are just so pathetic and kissing up? I'm going to get to Chuck Grassley. He's the oldest man serving in the House of Representatives. And he's all, my wife liked your speech. He said that to this woman, this Ketanji. You have praised the 1619 Project, which argues the U.S. is a fundamentally racist country and was founded in 1619. You have made clear you believe judges must consider critical race theory when deciding how to sentence criminal defendants, she said. Is it your personal hidden agenda, to incorporate critical race theory into our legal system? It's already there. Blackburn wasn't the only Republican to touch on race. Lindsey Graham spent most of his opening statement whining about Democrats' treatment of Justice Brett Kavanaugh, and then, who was credibly accused of sexual assault. But he said that Jackson's skin color had more to do with her nomination than her credentials. I want the Supreme Court to look more like the country. I want it to operate, but I want it to operate within the confines of the Constitution. That's that lame-o. Sorry, kids. Not to be name-calling Lindsey Graham, but he's not tough. He's kind of lame. Ted Cruz told... This is a Washington Compost headline. And then I will get to calls. Hang tight, guys. Ted Cruz, who's the RINO senator from Texas. What a shame that he's a RINO. Born in Calgary, I hear. He was born in Canada. He's less American than Nicolas. Did you know that? Or is he? I don't know. Ted Cruz told Ketanji Brown Jackson that Bushrod Washington was not controversial. He was an enslaver. That's what Julian Brockle says over at Washington Compost. And because he's talking about, it didn't used to be so politicized having these justices on the Supreme Court. Ooh, he was an enslaver. Give me a break. That's a positive thing. That means you're responsible for a lot of people's lives. If you're an enslaver, you're responsible for slaves. That means you are a leader. You take responsibility. That's almost as important as being like not almost as important. It's, you should be like a father, lead your family very well, that's a good indicator that you're a good leader. If you're an enslaver, if you owned slaves, that means that you had to hold an estate and handle a lot of people. That means you're a good leader, or at least you know how to delegate good leadership, possibly, or at least you have to have some form of leadership. So give me a break. Dana Milibank wrote another Washington Post compost article. Republicans start the Ketanji Brown Jackson hearing with race baiting and pedophile smears. Terrible, huh? What a joke. Is there anything else I wanted to show from this Ketanji thing? Oh yeah, Chuck Grassley. I almost forgot. This guy. Chuck Grassley joked with her, and I don't know, Senator Grassley jokes that his wife liked Ketanji Jackson, her opening statement. His wife, Barbara, thought she did a good job in her opening statement on Monday. She didn't have anything to say about my statement, he jokes. I don't know, man. I don't know. I want to like that guy because he's old and he's kind of old school, but he's been in Congress forever. And how decent has he been? You know? Pathetic. Taking care of businesses. You know, you really can't blame the RINOs for everything. Trump had three chances, to force hardcore right-wing justices onto the court, and he put up soft conservatives instead. Those were picked from the list of like some establishment so-called conservative judicial lists, right? He gave out his list of people that he would select. He also had to consider taking care of business, not to go too soft on Trump, but he also had to consider what would pass in the Senate, because the Senate has to confirm these people, and the Senate is a bunch of RINOs and Democrats. So, yeah, he could have challenged them a little bit more, perhaps. It would have been awesome had he not appointed that woman. And, you know, that guy, the first guy, Gorsuch, might be one of the worst of the ones that he picked. But also the woman, of course. And Kavanaugh is just a softy. Not good. Let me get to a call, and then I do have some super chats, including from yesterday, to get to. And I'm also going to talk about this trans agenda and gay agenda. Some people don't think that it's a big deal, but it's used to attack and take down. It's a part of the attack on men, which is part of the attack on whites, and it's a part of the attack on all decency and realness, respectability. Like, our country is becoming a joke. I mean, this Supreme Court thing is part of it. But let me get to William in California. William, thanks for calling and holding. How are you doing? Hey,
man, how you doing?
Fine, thank you.
Yeah, hey, shout out to Asmodor yesterday. He was on it.
Nice.
About the Ukraine thing. You remember last month I told you most people don't even know what they're talking about when it comes to Ukraine. But I tell you. We were just talking about this being their business, weren't we?
Yeah.
We were just talking about that happened in Cuba with Kennedy. He rolled the dice and said, no, you're not bringing those missiles here.
Yeah.
Okay. So, I mean, we kind of really need to stay away from that and everything and just imagine, like I said, imagine California succeeding away from the states. And the White House comes back 10 years later, and you know what they're going to do. We'll kill everybody in California unless you come back. But I think they've brought that to the table again about California leaving the states, but it ain't going to happen.
There's yeah.
Just too much on the table, too much vegetables and food grown here in California, too much oil, too many ports. We have some very important, we got the Port of Oakland, the Port of Long Beach. You also have the Pacific Fleet right there in San Diego. They ain't going to let California go. So everybody needs to get that out of their minds. And I think you need 3/4 of the Senate and the House to have that done, and it's probably highly unlikely.
Yeah, I mean, I think our involvement with Ukraine has only prolonged their suffering. And yeah. Our propping up of this, as JLP said, and Nick Stream reiterated, I don't know if you caught Nick Stream yesterday.
I missed it. I was supposed to catch it. I talked to him yesterday, and I missed it. I had something to do. Yeah.
Well, Jesse has on the Jesse Lee Peterson channel, he has a clip, and it's on JLP Highlights, by the way, Jesse Lee Peterson Highlights podcast, that this guy is on an ego trip, this Zelensky guy, Volodymyr Zelensky, who's not a Christian, yeah. by the way, and he's being, yeah. like, propped up and praised, and he's, like, not surrendering because he's being enabled with military weapons and yeah. money and all kinds of stuff to keep on yeah. fighting when it's we have no business helping them.
We're only causing more problems. Correct. And a lot of people don't realize that if you send those MiGs from, that was said to take it to Germany and then from Germany to Poland, then to Ukraine. You send those MiGs over there from Germany, and it's like opening the door to World War III, if you know anything about this stuff. And you really need to stay out of that.
To me, it's...
I noticed
it's
something
not even
about
a con- I'm not even necessarily concerned about World War III.
Right.
It's all manner of evil that the American, which I call it anti-American, establishment, is pushing around the world. And it's... They're pushing, like we've talked about so many times, the gay agenda worldwide, and they're—I don't know—it's nothing good, and it's nothing good for the American people.
No, I don't think it is. I mean, you said something about that judge, the one about the kids can pick their gender. I did not know that about her.
So
that's ridiculous.
So, yeah, according to Marsha Blackburn, if I read it correctly. Marsha Blackburn seems to imply or directly state that this Ketanji woman serves on the school board of a district that lets kids, kindergartners, pick their so-called gender.
I've been watching some of it, and I can tell you, they're probably going to confirm her. But
yeah.
I mean, I think Biden really crapped on her when he said, I'm going to pick a black woman. I mean, some of her qualifications probably are there, but she did represent people at Guantanamo Bay. I'm not a lawyer, but I don't think I would take that case.
I mean, that's like the least of my concerns, honestly. But
Yeah. But, I mean, some of those people went back to, well, most of them went back to the battlefield. I think Biden kind of crapped on her nomination when he said, I'm going to get a black person, black woman or whatever.
Yeah.
I think he crapped on it right then and there, and it made me think,
sorry, kids.
Here we go. Affirmative action at the Supreme Court level.
I know. And she's been, in my opinion, it's been affirmative action for her the whole way. Because they're... Even if it's not written on paper, it is the mindset of most people in America to kiss up to the blacks, and especially the black females.
Yeah, I mean, they're all getting a black card. You know what that is.
Yeah, and especially in the academic world and the political world, and that's where she lives. So.
Yeah, I think they're all hooked on getting this black card. And believe me, white people, you don't have to say you have black friends to make yourself whole. You don't.
I know.
Don't.
It's embarrassing.
It's embarrassing that she's doing that. I think that she was crapped on when he said, I'm getting a black woman. It was crapped in from day one.
I appreciate it, William. It's good to hear from you, man.
All right.
Great
and
call.
I appreciate Asmodor's call because Asmodor is a... He's a real good history buff, man. He really throws it out there right. And shout out to him. Shout out to Lord Grimm. Shout out to King Drop.
Nice.
And Rick Flamain. But, Asmodor is pretty good with that stuff, I really like to hear his calls.
Yeah, I think he was close with it. It seems like he was close with his father, so he's kind of logical, too, which is nice.
Yeah, men that were close to their fathers tend to be that way.
Yeah.
I kind of listened to my father quite a bit. I did a lot of stuff to... Now, he didn't tell me. Here's the deal. My father didn't tell me he knew that everything that I did, playing sports or whatever I did in school, he says everything you did, you were trying to impress me.
He knew that?
And yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, I
know
a lot of
kids fall into that type of
You know what I
mindset.
Mean? I kind of... No,
I was like that.
Bad, no, he wasn't saying it was a bad thing. He just
right.
recognized, he says, I recognize, William, that you do some of the things you do in your sports and your activities. You're doing it because you want me to be proud of you.
Yeah.
I wasn't saying
it's a bad thing either. Yeah.
Right. I mean, a lot of men, like you said, when they communicate with their fathers, they're very logical.
Yeah. Well, thank you, William. Take care, man.
All right. You have a good day, man.
You as well. Oh, my gosh. Little chat, side chat. Oh, you know what? Let me read a few of these super chats before I get to Joe in PDX. Joe from Portland, Oregon. Ragnar0321 gave a chat over there in Odyssey, ODYSEE.com. He said, what about the insurrection during the Kavanaugh confirmation hearings? Yeah, isn't that when those people interrupted a congressional hearing or something like that? Isn't that what a lot of these J6 protesters are charged with, these insurrectionists? They did the exact same thing. And these people were more womanly and destructive and nasty than the J6 people, who were all sweet and nice. Like, hey, how you doing? Nice to see you. I mean, some of them were aggressive, moshing. You don't mosh with the cops, guys. Come on. Some of you guys got carried away. You J6 patriots. You got a little carried away. Understandable, but don't do that. Be clear thinking, calm, alert, and aware. I know a lot of us slip up, but it's not wise because the hammer comes down hard, the commie hammer. Not good. Your girlfriend with the super chat on Odyssey, ODYSEE.com/@TheHakeReport. Nice impression of Brian Stelter while talking about the Kartnark. Speaking of Brian Stelter, talks like Mickey Mouse. There's another guy who does an impression of him called Mark Dice, who is a fellow fan of Jesse Lee Peterson, by the way. I know this on straight from the horse's mouth. A fellow fan of JLP, Mark Dice. Mark Dice, right? That's his name. He did an interesting video that I watched on this Dave Rubin situation, how the Republicans are just, oof. I mean, the RINOs, the establishment, so-called conservatives. Asmador with a super chat yesterday, I don't know if I read this one. He stated on Odyssey, Rubin and his partner, as in Dave Rubin, who's a fairly popular podcast, YouTube host, who said, oh, the left left me, or I left the left because the left left me. The left is no longer liberal. He considers himself a liberal, which is what the conservatives are now too, right? The so-called conservatives. And this guy, he has a partner, like a homosexual live-in partner, also named David, not Christians, creating babies in a lab. Rubin and his partner are creating babies in a lab, says Asmador, to raise in a gay household. Not the happy kind, right? Although they think they are, but they're not. It is ungodly, and in a sane society, they would be jailed for that. Yeah, I mean, It's not good for the children. It could be considered child abuse because you're teaching them wrong is right and right is wrong. So I remember seeing a clip of Charlie Kirk during the Groiper Wars when the Groipers were groiping Charlie Kirk and his black radical homosexual friend who protested against Don't Ask, Don't Tell during the Obama administration. I'm blanking on his name. Rob, whatever his name is. A black guy on TP USA, Turning Point USA, Rob Smith? This guy talked to Dave Rubin, Charlie Kirk did, in this clip. He's all, I personally am not for same-sex marriage, but I think you guys can do whatever you want. Gay, you can adopt children, whatever you want. And Dave Rubin's all, well, thank you. I agree, you same to you. Yeah. That's kiss up Charlie Kirk, whom I kind of liked. I still like him, but he's wrong. Kiss up, not good. Anyway, that's that. Asmodor states, MSM, as in mainstream media, reporters are now admitting that those schools and hospitals, and I assume that he's talking about the ones getting bombed, with the white-on-white crime as lame. I spit. Excuse me, guys. Jesse does it, I think. The lame Tony calling it white-on-white crime, Russian-on-Russian crime. Interesting that he calls it Russian-on-Russian. You know, this war that Putin is waging and Zelensky is waging it, too. Takes two to tango. And they're saying, oh, Putin is a war criminal. He's bombing hospitals and schools. Well, mainstream media reporters, according to Asmodor on the Super Chat, are now admitting that those schools and hospitals were retrofitted into military installations. Yeah, you know what? That crossed my mind. Because remember, a lot of you guys love Israel. I love Israel. But they were saying Israel is bombing, you know, killing children. And then there was a counter-narrative, including in the mainstream media, that Hamas and Palestine, they were using human shields. There was purportedly this clip where this guy was, like, carrying a child, this fighter with his gun. He was carrying a child in front of him and run into a place for, like, cover. And, like, what self-respecting Israeli IDF would ever shoot at a child, right? So I guess he was using it as a human, this child as a human shield so that he could get away. Because who would risk shooting a child? Well, that crossed my mind that maybe that's what's going on in Ukraine. Because there's so much propaganda. There is violence on many sides, to quote Trump. And it's so true. So true. Well, thank you guys. More Super Chats from actually yesterday, I think. JohnWX25 on streamlabs.com/thehakereport. Ask yourself a question. Donning plastic. This is a reference to my collar yesterday, donning armor. Ask yourself a question, donning plastic. Why do our lib scum commies hate him? Hate who? Oh, hate Putin. Yeah, okay. Because donning armor said Putin is a communist. But our lib scum commies, communists here in America, I consider them communists, hate Putin. He is a commie that knows the difference between real men and women, as well as he loves his country, says JohnWX25. Yeah. I don't think communism is quite the issue. It's globalist socialism, which is what NATO and this so-called America are for, against nationalism and, you know, like somebody who's challenging their power a little bit. That's Putin. The most interesting man in the world. JohnWX25 says Trump knew exactly how to deal with Putin and vice versa. Yeah, I think that they had some mutual respect and dealt with one another like men and not like women, girly, like fallen state women, you know? That's Biden and Blinken and all the rest. Lloyd Austin. How embarrassing the Biden administration is, huh? Making a joke out of the country. But that's our deep state and establishment that we've elected, many of us, including the RINOs. Shameful. JohnWX25, with another super chat this morning, says, I guess this may be addressed to Lindsey Graham. Praising a woman that gives leniency to child molesters should be enough to disqualify anyone but a black female named Ketanji. I'm correcting him, right? Ka, whatever. Only a Maze or Tony would support. I know. But it's more than just Maze and Tony supporting that mess. Well, I appreciate it, guys. Did I miss any others in the Odyssey during this thing? Okay, let me get to another call here. Joe in Portland, Oregon is on the line. Thank you for holding, Joe. What's up?
Hey, how are you?
Fine. How are you doing?
I'm well.
Nice.
Yeah, I just wanted to comment on the Supreme Court nominee, Jackson, whatever her name is.
Ketanji Onyika Brown Jackson.
Yeah. Yeah, I can't pronounce that.
Oh.
Racist. I'll just say Jackson.
Yeah. I like to say Ketanji because the liberals call her Jackson. And normally when it's a woman politician, you refer to her by her first name. And even though she's a judge, not supposed to be a politician, she's a total politician. So anyway.
Okay, well, I'll say her first name. What is it, Jumanji?
Ketanji.
What is it?
Ketanji.
Oh, Ketanji.
Yeah.
Okay, oh, Ketanji. Okay. So how is it that when Biden says that he wants a black woman to be the next Supreme Court nominee, how does that not violate the Civil Rights Act of 1964?
Is that, like, no discrimination based on race type thing?
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't know if the president has, like, power to do whatever he wants, however he wants, for whatever reason he wants. I used to love those signs that we would see in restaurants that said, "We reserve the right to refuse service to anyone." And I think it used to be for any reason. Wouldn't that be lovely to have that in America? Where it's like, okay, you're supporting him based on the fact that she's you're supporting her based on the fact that she's a black woman and she's a liberal.
Yeah.
And you think that she can pass because the RINOs are supporting her, right? Well, we're going to support a white, straight white Christian man of power who's rich and old and a based because he's white. Eat it. And I think that that could maybe get some support if we started freeing up the right to discriminate. But you're right.
Yeah, I don't know. It's hard to say.
Yeah.
And also, how can someone feel good about themselves knowing that they were partially chosen just because of their race or sex or sexual orientation or whatever?
Yeah.
You know, how can you look at yourself in the mirror and feel good about yourself? I don't get that.
You know, I think that you just take what you can get. Like, everybody's got a hookup. I think they may tell themselves that whites have had the in-group preference for the past 400 years into this day. like, now it's our turn. Get ours. Because... Well, go ahead.
It's an anti-white sentiment. They're trying to get rid of white people.
Yeah.
You know, and this is
the
beginning of it.
Yeah, I remember that.
They're using equity as an excuse and all this crap. It's really, they have an agenda to get rid of white people. You know, they love talking about how white people are going to be a minority soon. They can't wait for that. They're promoting intermixed marriages on TV and commercials.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of commercials you see, it's like they're trying to encourage people to have mixed marriages.
Yeah.
You know, they're brainwashing the youth.
And they're trying to call it racist if you're not for it, which every race I know that's been traditional, especially the fathers, they're not for that. They don't want their daughter or son going with another one. They may, like, convince themselves, oh, it's fine, whatever. But traditionally, nobody likes that.
Yeah.
So anyway.
Not natural.
Yeah.
They're trying to, like, push the whole gay thing on everyone and on kids, and they're teaching it in school and making children think that that's normal.
Yeah. You
know? And that's just sick, in my opinion.
Yeah, I agree. Did I argue with you about... I feel like I mentioned you yesterday.
You did.
What were we...
About Bill Cosby.
Oh, yeah, I was arguing with you about Bill Cosby. I don't want to start that again.
Yeah.
Unless you want to, but...
Yeah. No, I think we...
Do you agree that it's partly an attack on men and partly an attack specifically because he called out the blacks to be more responsible?
I mean, I do agree that a lot of people hate him. A lot of liberals hate him for those reasons.
So it adds to their motivation to take him down for this Me Too thing.
Yeah, I agree with that 100%. I'm sure that all the leftists were, you know, really happy when these allegations came out against him.
What was that guy's name? Burgess? Hannibal Burris. I keep on wanting to say Burgess Owens, who's like a supposedly a black conservative guy, I think. But Hannibal Burris, he said he was the one who made this thing go viral. I remember seeing it or hearing it on TMZ years back. Hannibal Burris, this black comedian, does his bit saying, mocking Bill Cosby for saying, pull up your pants. And this guy is like, but you rape women, Bill Cosby. So in other words, he's attacking Bill Cosby for allegedly raping women, but he's saying it in reaction to Bill Cosby telling blacks to pull up their pants. So,
right.
There you go. From the start.
Yep.
Yeah. Anyway, good to hear from you, Joe, in PDX, Portland, Oregon.
Yeah, All right, good talking with you, Hake, as always.
Nice. Take care, man.
All right, brother. Bye.
Bye. Let me look. I wanted to cover this gay trans agenda thing, but I think I'd like to, before that, cover this January 6th mess. I'll save the gay trans agenda for the second hour, guys. We're coming up on it. I have another Huntington song to share with you. In Hake News, at the end of hour two, I believe, I covered how they're saying, and I have just a couple of CNN headlines on this. Mike Pence had to go into hiding underneath the Capitol at a loading dock. Loading dock. I guess it's not water, right, underneath the Capitol. I don't know. But a loading dock, purportedly, maybe trucks come, right? Underneath the U.S. Capitol, under the U.S. Capitol building during the January 6th riot. So said a U.S. Secret Service inspector testifying yesterday. I honestly have not kept up with these January 6th patriots. I know that some of you have. There's one woman who has, who's a journalist for, I forget which outlet, Julie something. But this detail was revealed during the, listen to this, second trial? Why a second trial? For a defendant, Coy Griffin, C-O-U-Y. There it is, Mike Pence. You guys hate him, or you're okay with him? He had to go into hiding, according to the Secret Service. Which, understandable, right? This Coy Griffin guy, apparently in a second trial. I don't know why he needed a second trial. Maybe their case is just that flimsy that they're going taking him to trial again. And here's the first guy who went to trial. This is a drawing. I'm showing you another person who went to trial, Guy Reffitt. He's the first January 6th defendant not to take a plea deal, but to go to trial. His own son worked with the feds, the FBI, the deep state, to take him down. I think I heard. I saw it on TKR Official over there on Telegram. By the way, I'm on Telegram. JLP Talk is on Telegram. It's Jesse Lee Peterson's Telegram. I'm on Telegram, The Hake Report. TKR Official is on there. Many other banned people. But Guy Reffitt, his own son, testified against him. And his son, they're like teenagers. His son and daughter, teenagers. Supposedly he threatened them. Said, oh, you know what, traitors get shot. Something like that. Guys get out of control. Coy Griffin, C-O-U-Y. Not familiar with that name. Coy Griffin, or Coy or Coy? Sorry, it's an he's an American. He's like Cowboys for Trump politician. And I saw footage of him, and he's just being happy and excited, and he's at the January 6th outside the Capitol. Like, there's nothing wrong with, seemingly, what he did. Maybe he did other stuff that you can't see. But he's a New Mexico guy, I think. Tularosa, New Mexico. And I think that he was, the second trial. Maybe it's for a different thing. Anyway, he's charged with misdemeanors. Misdemeanors in this capital attack. Most of these people are charged with misdemeanors. Misdemeanors are less less tough than felonies, okay? The first time federal law enforcement confirmed where Pence went after he was evacuated from the Senate chamber during the breach. Prosecutors worked to prove during the trial yesterday how rioters jeopardized the security perimeter around Pence. Whose fault is that? And many of these people were not rioters. They were just protesters who were wanderers, really. They were just wandering about, mulling around inside the Capitol building, looking around. Some of them were acting goofy, going into, like, Nancy Pelosi's office, putting their feet on the desk, posing for a picture at the behest of phony photojournalists and stuff. That's their fault if they didn't have enough security. I heard that Trump wanted more security. That's what I heard. And I heard that they did not get enough security. Was it a setup? I don't know. They seem to be eager. It seems kind of like they're letting Ukrainians get killed. I was listening to the crypto report, and Asmodor was saying how he was predicting that they were just going to let more and more civilians die so that they justify, you know, us coming down harder on Russia. In other words, keep enabling Ukraine to keep this war going. Because if they weren't enabled, they would have said uncle a long time ago, or mercy, or stop, 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 stop. Or yes, you can have Mariupol, or whatever. I forget which cities they were supposed to give up. But anyway, this the jeopardizing the security perimeter around Mike Pence and the mostly peaceful Capitol protest is an important distinction for the prosecution of certain protesters charged with entering and remaining in the restricted area inside the Capitol building, as well as disorderly conduct. I laugh because it's such an attack on the Capitol that they got charged with misdemeanors, disorderly conduct, and remaining in a restricted area. Such a benign attack, am I right? And I know that there were some scenes that looked uglier than others, but there were scenes like 1,400 hours or 14,000 hours that the deep state didn't want to release because it shows them just mulling about and doing nothing. It wasn't an organized attack. It was not an armed insurrection. I don't know if anybody entered the building with any gun that they owned, with any gun, other than the cops, so-called cops. Jokes of cops, affirmative action cops. Ashley Babbitt, rest in peace. So this first defendant, Guy Reffitt, the guy who they hand-drew the picture of him, because I guess there's no cameras in the courtroom oftentimes. Guy Reffitt, the guy whose son turned him in, whose wife said, don't take a plea deal, don't go to trial. Guy Reffitt asked a federal judge to throw out his conviction and to schedule a new trial. Very interesting. I mean, I don't see us winning in the courts, although it can happen in some cases. There are honorable judges, I think, I assume, and there are honorable lawyers. I usually say lawyers are liars, and that is the case. Let every man be a liar. Spineless VP, says Lisa. let God be true and every man a liar, right? And especially lawyers. The more intellectual you are, the more you rationalize all kinds of evil and finagle good to be evil and evil to be good. So it's a test case for scores, meaning 20s, many 20s more protesters facing this political persecution. What a shame, huh? It is the top of the hour, guys. Let's play some music. Huntingtons is back. I've been playing them for like 3 weeks almost. Last week of Huntingtons, guys, I promise, maybe. This is from the 2000 album, Plastic Surgery, track number 11, getting up there. I Don't Want to Go Out With Her by Huntingtons. Enjoy, you musical Philistines, grin and bear it. Cover your ears, press mute, or enjoy, and I'll be back for hour two. Hang tight, Huntingtons.
She told her friends that we're a thing and she won't leave me alone. I wish she'd go away.
Wait a minute. This ain't devil music, Hake. What the? I want to be sedated, says Joseph 461. Yes, Huntingtons are noted and highly respected Ramones clones. I believe that they may have been like one of the premier Ramones clones bands back in the day. I don't know if they're still around, Huntingtons. Huntingtons, for one, you want to listen to Ramones, but also support Christian values. They do rock, says outcasted influencer 8U. Thank you. I don't want to be buried in a pet cemetery. I prefer the devil music, to be honest. Hard to believe these dorks are in their 40s now. Did you know that that's a bad word? I better not get into that. White boy music is so cool and fun. Indeed, it is. Matt Living the Dream says about the January 6th situation, if Trump was any kind of leader, he would have seen the play and countered it. He didn't counter it. He gave it to them. What a shame. What a shame. And he's laughing. yeah, don't fall. Honestly, the men who fell for this, you know, fell into the trap, they should have seen it coming too. We are supposed to be responsible for ourselves, for sure. But nonetheless, pray for Derek Chauvin, former officer Derek Chauvin. Pray for George Zimmerman, falsely smeared in the mainstream media and by the useful idiot suckers, some of whom are calling my show to this day and thinking that Trayvon was murdered.
To this day.
Pray for Roddy Bryan and Travis and Gregory McMichael. Pray for the J6 Patriots. And pray for, all of the falsely accused and railroaded men of all races. Bill Cosby. Should I count that one guy in it who's saying, I believe I can fly? Should we pray for him too? What's his name? I'm blanking on his name, but he's a singer. I believe I can fly. Should we pray for him? He's being smeared for being a male. I mean, some people say that he was doing bad things. Who hasn't done bad things? They're going after the men. They're going after the whites. Make sure you pray for them. And pray for your enemies, too, right? Be good to them. Yeah, R. Kelly, thank you. So many men, so many whites, and it's getting more and more out of control. Pray for that lady. Said, taser, 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 blam, oops. Oh, no. This lady, she shot a young, out of control, mixed thug, son of a white mother and a black father, purportedly white, with her white woman tears that weren't enough. Unfollow, says t.me, vigilante patriot, Q-T, patriot. What's up to the Facebook crew, the faithful few, and the D-Live people? I'm on YouTube, I'm on Odyssey, I'm even on Twitch. Nice to see all of ya. Did I miss anything? Twitter, of course. And you can listen live through TSL, TalkStream Live, and JLP Live. Okay. Let me cover this attack on the kids, because it's pretty disgusting. And I've covered this a little bit yesterday. But the far-left female run outlet, The Skim, reports Indiana, yesterday, Governor Eric Holcomb, Republican from Indiana, RINO, I say he's a RINO, I don't know anything about this guy. He vetoed a bill banning transgender girls, which is female for actual boys, from playing in female sports in schools. You know, these lame Republicans are not, they're drawing the line at, not at transgenders being all, to me that's kind of public indecency, like public vulgarity, being vulgar in public, right? Public something. But no. That's okay. But if you're trying to get into female sports, well, that's where we draw the line. As if anybody cares about female sports. But anyway, they're pretending to protect the kids. Earlier this month, Indiana's Republican-dominated legislature passed a bill that prohibited transgender girls, meaning boys who feel like they're girls, in K through 12, kindergarten through 12th grade, that's age 5 through the end of high school, from playing on girls' sports teams, and argued that all of this was in the name of fairness. Turns out the lawmakers apparently can't prove that transgender athletes outperform others. Give me a break. Now, Eric Holcomb, the governor, Republican governor, who had shown support for the idea behind the bill, is going against his own party. He refused to sign the ban, questioning whether the bill solved any pressing issues. Coward, I say. But even the Indiana lawmakers who could override this veto, I call them cowards too. You all know about Leah Thomas. I forget what this person's real name is. Dare I dead name him? One is a swimmer, right? Olympics or something. I don't even know. Libs and the conservatives pretend to be all mad about women's sports getting invaded by these dudes who are like, still obviously have like dude bodies. Skinny, but still dudes. And they're pretending like, oh, we need to protect. They even came out with this meme. Where was this? I saw this in the gay agenda trans mess. Let's see here. Leah Thomas. They included this George Orwell quote. These so-called conservatives. George Orwell, 1984. The party told you to reject the evidence of your eyes and ears. It was their final, most essential command. And George Orwell wrote this fiction book called 1984. It was kind of apocalyptic about how the party would control you through your mind and you through intimidation and brainwash you to believe that right is wrong and wrong is right. And don't believe your lying eyes. believe our statistics. I argued with this woman, Hunter Avalon's wife, who said that she looked at statistics to find out that she supported the gay agenda, same-sex marriage, or the gays being all out in the open and shameless about their degeneracy, right? Their perversion. And she used statistics to support it, not just common sense. Man and man, this doesn't go together. I'm doing a gesture. It's a clean gesture, I think. Clean enough. It doesn't go together. A child knows this. That's why I have to target the children and brainwash them and pervert them and have them be raised by two males. And then they have these females writing these books. I've covered these children's books. Such and such as two dads. Such and such as two moms. Not. So fake. So false. So female. Such a perversion of reality. Right? And that's true. By the way, is Babylon B still suspended? This Rachel Levine guy who's... he's the, I think they tweeted this out, and I think that they're supposed to delete the tweet. I don't think that Twitter has deleted the tweet. And I think they're suspended, and I've been suspended in this way before on Twitter before, where I was arguing with a black female about, you know, after Obama's portrait artist had previously done portraits of black females holding severed heads, meaning cut off the heads of white females, and shown it, you know, it's paintings of black females holding severed heads of white females, ladies. And there's a black artist who painted Obama's portrait, one of the Obamas, right? Either Barack or Big Mama, right? I'm blanking on her name. And I argued with this black female, and she's all, ooh, slavery, ooh, whites used to own blacks as slaves, and ooh, lynchings. I'm like, blacks kill more than twice as many whites every year as vice versa. And what did Twitter do? She must have flagged my tweet, right? This is like some Black Panther woman. She flagged my tweet, I guess, and Twitter declared it to be promoting violence. Because I'm citing FBI statistics. I literally just said blacks kill more than twice as many whites as vice versa every year. Year in and year out. And it's FBI stats. I mean, everybody knows it. I mean, everybody who's looked into it knows it. So they forced me to delete the tweet and then I could be unsuspended. I guess that's what's happening to Babylon B, who tweeted out, Babylon B's man of the year. Babylon B is a... like the Christian version of The Onion. The Onion used to do fake headlines, and now Babylon Bee is doing fake satirical headlines. Babylon Bee's man of the year is Rachel Levine. Such a man. And it's this dude who's wearing long hair, and he goes by Rachel Levine, and I think Biden has him as one of the U.S. Assistant Secretary of Health for the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, right? Assistant Secretary of Health, this fat person in a dress, fat man in a dress. And of course, the people are like, it was cheap, salacious. This guy named Marco Descartes, or Mark, whatever his name is, called it cheap, salacious, unfunny, and transphobic bigotry. It's not bowing to wokeness, it's penalizing bigotry. No, man, you're the bigot, because the bigot, the word bigot, I had never heard of it before the liberals started using it, but I looked it up in the dictionary before the fake news dictionary changed the definition. Bigotry used to mean someone who can't handle other people's points of view, and that's them. They can't handle the truth, so they're the bigot. Another person says, so Twitter banned the account for breaking TOS? Mockingly. TOS is terms of service, right? Since when was transphobia satire? Asks some spooky bones person. Excuse me. There's no such thing as transphobia. They're not, although sometimes the transgenders can be a bit scary. But that's not transphobia. That's like freakish man in a dress scary. That's different. But that's since always, people have always mocked that. You know, men in dresses, men who are acting girly. That has always been satire, dummy. Anyway. So they suspended the web. Is Babylon Bee still suspended? It was covered even in Fox News. Babylon Bee was defiant, according to Fox News yesterday, after Twitter locked their account, locked it, after a tweet naming Rachel Levine as Man of the Year. Terrible, huh? What a mess. Gross. Bad stuff. Washington compost, by the way. And then I will get to Alexander in California coming up next. Washington compost shared this other thing. This is just part of the gay agenda. You'll notice that they don't promote whites. They don't say, "Oh, look how much whites have done so good for the country." No, it's about how bad the whites were. And most of the stuff that they say was bad wasn't even bad. Slavery wasn't bad inherently. Was not inherently bad. But they want to say, "Oh no, by definition, you're not an honorable person." Washington Compost back in 2018 and Pocket. The far-left Pocket, which promotes this stuff, to this day, is promoting it. Kayla Epstein.
To this day!
Kayla Epstein. Epstein, not a Christian, probably. Wrote this article called "The King and His Husband, The Gay History of British Royals" in the Washington Compost in 2018. Shared in, and there's in this female, look, they have a picture of this purported king named Edward II. And Washington Compost is sure to tell you, King Edward II was known for his intensely close relationships with men. That doesn't mean that he was gay. I don't know anything about it, nor do I want to know. But these filthy women and female-minded males want to push this stuff. So sick. This historian and author, Carolyn Harris, interviewed this Washington Compost writer Kayla Epstein and promoted it on her blog website. And talked about, who says the royals aren't a modern family? And that's a reference to this degenerate TV show, Modern Family, by the way. This Carolyn Harris, another who's promoting the Washington Compost article. So sick, huh? Females. That's why you can't trust every historian. I only trust the our resident historians over there on Odyssey, Brandon M. Asmodor over there. And those guys. Fat mentally ill man helps run the Department of Health. What a joke, huh? Shaking my head. What a joke of a country. Yeah, they're trying to say that stuff about Jesus. So sick. Let me get to Alex in California. Alexander. I shouldn't shorten the name. That's inappropriate. Alexander in California, thanks for calling, man. Thanks for holding. What's up?
Well, James, you can call me whatever you want. There's no need to feel ashamed about that, James. Call me whatever you want to call me, Alex, that's fine.
Hey, long time no here. How are you doing?
I'm doing amazing. How are you doing, James?
Doing well.
Okay. Well, anyway, James, to start this off, I want to point out that I am not alt-right.
Okay.
After a lot of free thinking, I actually am, to kind of point to me of viewers, I'm actually anti-racist.
Are you on a speakerphone or a Bluetooth? You're coming through a little muffled.
Oh, no, I'm sorry, James. Do I come clear now?
Yeah, stay close to your phone and speak up loud and clear.
Okay, James. Anyway, I am an anti-racist, so that may disappoint some of your audience members that actually that's what I've become.
You're anti-white? Is that what you're saying?
I said anti-racist. I am white, but like you should, if you want to get into like the nuances of what my anti-racism brand is, like you can interview me, but like you may not have time to do that, to understand.
Oh yeah, don't be anti-racist. Racism doesn't exist. It's just a smear on whites.
Yeah, okay, we can agree to disagree on that. I mean, okay. I think you're entitled to your opinion, James. I don't want to have anyone take you down off big tech.
It's a fact. It's not an opinion. But anyway, that doesn't sound like that was the point of your call. Go ahead.
Okay. Anyway, like, I have this other question. You know, you follow Richard Spencer on Twitter. I've seen that. You follow him, right?
Yeah.
He has said that the alt-right should vote Democrat and not conservative. What do you think of that?
I think he's wrong. He's an atheist, so he's given up on America. And I think that he said that he, at least when he was interviewed by Jesse Lee Peterson some years back, he said he gave up on America. And
well, I'll let you finish, James. Sorry.
And so I don't think that we should give up and start voting for Democrats. I think that's
okay.
Too trolly.
What he says, though, is that if every other race is tries to pursue its interest on explicitly racial grounds, whites will inevitably do the same. That's why he votes Democrat.
Are you a white Christian?
I am. It's hard to tell if I'm white or if I'm not. You have to see, like, a picture of me. And you,
you said that you're white.
Yourself, but, like,
are you a Christian?
What? What?
Are you a Christian?
Well, I may not be white, but I went to Catholic school, so my answer to that is a yes, I am a Christian.
Okay. All right, man. Well, yeah, I don't agree with that. You don't agree with, Asmodor with the Super Chat says, Richard Spencer is a liberal and always has been. Yeah. So he's a liberal, so he's, I don't even know if, I think that he's one of the people who was pushing the alt, being called alt-right, and so that's fine. If those guys want to do that, they can. I don't support it. What do you think about voting for Democrats?
Well, I actually have become one of them pretty recently. It's like I am. I've given a long definition of it on my Instagram account, but
you've become alt-right or
no
Democrat.
What?
You've become alt-right, or you've become Democrat?
I have become a Democrat. I've never been alt-right. I've always been either... I used to be a mainstream conservative, then I became more of an anti-racist.
How old are you?
It's a long story.
How old are you?
I'm 20.
You're only 20?
How do I sound?
I don't know. I cannot tell.
Okay, I'm 20.
Yeah. And, well, man, it's good to hear from you again. I'm sorry to hear that.
Okay, I think we're all entitled to opinions, James. I still am a big fan of your show, even though I do not agree with you on a lot of things now.
No problem. I appreciate that, man. You doing JLP's silent prayer?
Yeah, I agree with Jesse, definitely, that anger is bad. That's one area where I definitely still agree with you guys, that anger is never okay and that people should always try to discern. But that's one thing I always take away from you guys.
Nice. Do you do his silent prayer?
Yes, I do. I do it every morning and every night.
Oh, right on, man. Well, I wish you well, Alexander. It's nice to hear from you again. Take care, man.
Have a nice day, James.
You as well. He's a nice guy. 20 years old. I didn't know he was 20. Yeah. Let me get to Lord Grimm. He wants to talk about this transgender agenda. Lord Grimm in Washington, D.C. How are you doing?
Hey, what's going on? Hey, everything all right, man?
It's going all right. You sound kind of rough, like you're on a speakerphone or Bluetooth or something.
I'm not, but
okay.
How about now?
I think you're sounding a little better. Stay close to your phone and stay still in a place that's good connection.
I got you. So pretty much, I was looking at something on Instagram like 5 minutes ago, and they were saying that that trans swimmer, I don't even want to say the name because it's not,
yeah.
The name is not even...
I understand that. But, I agree with you, actually. I should have called him, her, blah, 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 blah. I mean,
yeah,
blah, 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 blah.
I feel like when we do that, we make it worse for real. Cause
the more people who
people feel good about being bad, the more like people will feel good about being bad. It's just common sense, you know what I mean? So I don't really want to, you know, address that person by that name. But anyways, I saw something on Instagram on my story, or like the stories, and and it was like this picture of her, and it was like underneath it said how broke so many records as a woman.
Yeah.
Pretend to be a woman, but when it was a man identifying as a man, it was like number 400 or something, like in the world or something like that.
Yeah. Yep. I think you're right on that. Interesting.
That's crazy, man. So like you take a guy who is like not even that good as a guy, and you put him in the field with women, and he just dominates. That's crazy.
Yeah. So I'm looking at the Wikipedia for this misguided young male.
And so to be honest, you know, I don't really want to I want to be politically correct for the sake of your show.
Right.
But I want to be real at the end of the day too, because people know, like, I don't mind speaking my mind, but I'm gonna try to be, you know, not too bad. But listen, this is not a good thing, man.
No.
And I feel like just like you said, it's an agenda. It's a gay agenda. And all that stuff is of Satan. All that stuff is evil, man. And the more people who who buy into that stuff and just let it ride out, like they've been doing for the past few years, they've just been letting it ride out, letting the LGBT people do their thing and have their way. And now it's just like it's creating a whole mess. You know what I mean? And now, you know, you got women who work their whole lives to try to like be the best woman, be the best they could be as a real woman.
Yeah.
And then you got a guy who just like, it's just ridiculous, man. And then people, I just want to know how do the actual females that compete with this person or around this person, how do they really, like, I really want to know how they feel. I want to look into that and see how they feel, because I mean, I wonder if they accepting this. Like, I haven't really dug that far, but I'm just like, it's just real ridiculous, man. And this is the start. You know, if people let this ride out, it's going to, you know, create something more. Like, you know how these people are. Like, if you give them an inch, they're going to take a whole foot. They're going to take a whole mile if they can. You know
right.
what I mean? You know what I mean? So, you know, like the whole mass thing, we showed them that they can pretty much control us, tell us what to do. And now they just going power hungry with that. You know what I mean? So you let one trans person compete, it's going to be a whole swarm of them coming soon. You know, I mean, it's just ridiculous. And I feel like if they really want to do things like sports and stuff like that, have your own little trans little it league and all that with all your little trans people and stuff, man.
Yeah.
You know, don't interfere with the real women who are born women who don't have shoulders like a basketball player, man.
Right.
You know, like, come on now. You know what I'm saying? And if you really look at that person, that trans swimmer, it still looks every bit of a man, just like the so-called woman of the year. What's that guy named? ABL said something funny. He said she looked like it looks like the woman of the year. I forgot his name, Rachel Levine, whatever. ABL said he looked like the penguin from the Batman movie.
True.
But I mean, you know, these people are like clearly like them, like it's like a mental thing going on. You know, they're clearly mentally ill.
Yeah.
And you know, people just giving them praise and stuff and making them feel good about it. You know what I mean? And you know, we gotta come to reality, man. It's certain lines that we're not supposed to be crossing like this. And people just letting people just cross and do what they want. Like they say, do what thou wilt. You know that little
satanic,
probably evil. It's an evil agenda, man. There's no limits. There's no boundaries. Just do whatever you want. You know, if you feel like an animal, if you feel like a dog, you just call yourself Scooby-Doo or something. I mean, it's just ridiculous, man.
You know, there are perverted, sexually perverted people who are getting into that type of a thing, too, like the furries and all that mess. And it's just emasculating the males. It's just embarrassing.
They got the bestiality and all that stuff that's been going, you know, going for a little bit, but and, you know, to be honest, man, I feel like this world is really going to hell in a handbasket, man. And I'm just being real. Like, I want to have hope for it.
Yeah.
But I feel like the kingdom, like Jesse said, is within.
Right.
We can't be looking outwardly in this world because it's corrupt. It's getting more corrupt by the day, by the second. And it's nothing really good out here for us. We got to find good within ourselves.
Yeah.
And, you know, really, honestly, man, we can't depend on this world. You know, nothing of this world. It's good, and it's just getting worse and worse and worse, man.
Yeah. I agree, yep. Lord Grimm.
Yep, that's it, man. So I just wanted to say that, and everybody have a wonderful day. I'll be in the chat tuning in. I'm just kind of, like, busy a little bit, so I don't really get to tune in like I want to all the time. But when I can, I will, though. You know, I'll be up in there.
Nice. Thanks again, Lord Grimm. Yep. Take care.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. You too.
All right. What did Matt Live in the Dream says? It's always been hell. And, you know, there was a lot of degeneracy even listed in the Bible. So that is true. It has always been hell. And JLP has asked the question in church, do you think the world's ever going to change? He said it's not going to change. And he said it in response to, I think, Bill Lockwood saying that he has given up hope for America. But he hasn't gone to supporting Democrats like Richard Spencer. Like Asmodor points out, Spencer's always been a liberal. But Bill Lockwood still fights for what's right, regardless of whether there's quote-unquote hope for America or not. You put your hope in God, right? The end is near, Hake? No. These things must happen, as Matt, Living the Dream, said. It's always been this way. You tell the truth, though. Be a light in the world. Hide it under a bushel. No! I'm going to let it shine, right? And that's why I don't support the, I don't respect pronouns. I respect the people. I respect Bruce Jenner too much to call him a her or call him Caitlyn. People, you know, the terms of service of so many of these establishment social media companies say that's dead naming. Dead naming is when you call them the name, call him the name that he was before he changed his name to Caitlyn. And Ben Shapiro respects the legal name change, but, and so therefore he calls him Caitlyn, and he calls him a him still, but he'll give caves on the legal thing. No, I'm not for that. I'm going to call him Bruce because it's his name. I respect him too much. I respect the so-called transgender people so much that I'm not going to go along with their wrong. And what's his name? Big Bump says, say his name, Will Thomas. I guess that's, is that dead naming too? I respect young Mr. Thomas, 22 or 23 years old, born in 1998 or 1999, when I was graduating from high school or going into my senior year, whatever. This guy was being born, has one brother whom they call Leah Thomas, right? Leah Catherine Thomas. Barf, barf. Sorry, kids. Don't say barf. I never liked that word when I was a kid. I prefer to call it throw up. But Will Thomas, grew up in Austin, Texas, and has an older brother. Will Thomas began swimming at the age of 5, according to Wikipedia, which does not mention born Will Thomas, by the way. And so I'm trusting Big Bump as my source for the true name of this young man. Talented swimmer, but not beats all the ladies, right on. I respect that. I remember I thought I was a pretty good swimmer. I used to swim at grandma's house. I was really good at Marco Polo. Marco Polo is that game in which if you're the it person, you have to close your eyes and keep your eyes closed. Don't peek. And it's basically tag. You have to tag somebody. You say, Marco! And if the other person hears, if the other people hear you, they say, Polo! Marco! Polo! Fish out of water! No, no. Fish out of water is if you get out of the water and you, before you jump back in, they say fish out of water, then that person is essentially tagged and they're it. I was very erratic as an unpredictable, as the it person in Marco Polo. So I thought I was pretty good for a swimmer. I would swim laps and things. When I was injured in high school and college, I would swim a lot of laps. So I was a pretty good swimmer. But then I went to Pasadena City College, PCC, and there was this female Mexican cross-country runner woman who had, like, actually good form and was pretty fast, a challenge. I don't know if I beat her or not. I don't remember. But this guy was beating even the women, so he's reasonably talented. But Will Thomas was 6th in the state high school swimming championships. In where? Okay, Texas. Okay, all right. Do people swim in Texas? It's a big state, right? They don't really have... How much beach do they have? They probably have a decent amount of beach in the Gulf of Mexico. After his freshman year in University of Pennsylvania... Oh, no. Listen to this. Towards the end of high school, Will Thomas began to question, they say her, his, quote-unquote, gender identity, gender misidentity. What a confused person. Wonder how, if he had both parents or what. Misguided young man. Now being propped up. He has a mean butterfly stroke. That was the toughest one. That's tough. But I did learn how to do it. I was okay. I was really good at Marco Polo. Children's game. Be quiet, Lori BB42. Don't say that. I didn't say that she beat me. And she was short, too. But anyway. Will Thomas's brother. Okay, so after freshman year at University of PA, Pennsylvania, during the summer of 2018, this Will Thomas young man, young male, came out as so-called transgender to his so-called her family. Brother also attended U of PA. Shameful, huh? What a mess. That's that one where it was viral and Fox News kept showing it. He finished the race, and then, like, the second place person had another, like, lap or two to go. And a lap is there and back, right? A full lap, there and back. Crazy. Crazy. More than a lap to go. Yeah, so what a shame. Not a good situation. By the way, a couple of Super Chats guys, Big Bump told me yesterday, Kumbaya, my lord. Remember I was making fun of a... Well, I was joining in to Kanye West, who calls him Ye, himself Ye now, Ye, right? Or Ye? He posted a screenshot of that guy, the light-skinned, so-called black host of Daily Show, Trevor Noah. Posted a screenshot of him, Google image search, and said, "All together now, Kumbaya, my lord." But he said, instead of Kumbaya, he said, "Kunbaya." Or Kablimbaya, because supposedly that's a bad word worth... All of a sudden, it's worth censoring. JLP has been called on the Coon Train Awards for years. Not censored on YouTube or anything, but all of a sudden... Let me move it to a place where you can actually see it. All of a sudden, the IG, Mama IG, Instagram, Meta, Facebook, wants to say, oh, this is a bullying, harassment, Plantation Celebration Award, the Coon Train. And this is like a picture of a just a total caricature of a clowny looking blackface character. I gotta take a picture of it and show it to you guys. It's funny. But, oh man, it's kind of tough to capture. anyway, I'm taking pictures. Sorry, guys. Let me focus on the show here. You know what? Big Bump, I thought that Kumbaya meant something in, like, African or something. Like, what does this mean? K-U-M-B-A-Y-A. Kumbaya, my lord. But, actually, Big Bump told me, and I think this is true, that's black, as in, like, Negro black, old school Negro black in America. Come by here, my lord. Come by here, my lord. Come. By. Yeah. Here, my lord. Did you know that? He's all, I sang that song thousands of times. He went to a church in Florida, would sing it during a benediction. Come by ya, my lord. Come by ya. And the whites sing it. Hippies. So lame. I remember I would occasionally go to Sunday school. Most of the time, oftentimes I would skip Sunday school when I was going to the Presbyterian church. And this woman, it was on the tip of my tongue. I almost said her name. I think she remarried. Oh my gosh, I want to say her name, but like she was kind of a joke to us cousins, the children. But she had us singing Kumbaya, I think. What a shame. I think she also, one of these ladies, had us singing like, Prince of Peace and Lord, King of Kings and Lord and Lord's Glory, Hallelujah, but in Spanish. Rey, 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 y señores, señores, gloria. And she had us memorizing it, I guess because she saw the invasion and went right along with it, right? So bad. Anyway, more Super Chats. Ledge Klinger says, sadly, William Thomas's quote-unquote success swimming against women affirms, in his mind, that he is a woman. Clearly, William is deeply narcissistic and always considered himself a champion. In reality, he stinks! He says a different word. S-U-C-K-S. Don't say that, kids. If the world bows and condones this behavior, then the world loses all objective credibility. Yeah. Such a shame. Such a bad way to live, to quote Marvin Gaye. John WX25 says, when you don't protect the children, then you are no different than, no, it's different from, or if you're British, different to, a pedophile. Trans whatever, teaching to kindergarten is amount to grooming them for a gay, for the gay and lesbians. Gays and lesbians. Yeah, you know, I don't know if you're no different from a pedophile, but you're, you are what Jesus said. Anyone who offends these children, it's better for them to, it would be better for them to have a large millstone tied around their neck and be thrown into the sea than to be misleading the children. That's so wrong and so evil. And the women are doing it, and the female-minded males. Anyway, it's a long side note. Let me get to my favorite caller, Maze in Dayton, Ohio. How are you doing, Maze?
Hello, James. How are you today?
Fine. How are you?
That's good.
Nice.
Well, now, what's the problem you have with the lady that they're trying to confirm as the next justice?
I have no problem with her. I just don't, she does not belong as a judge or as a Supreme Court so-called justice.
Why not?
What?
Why not?
Because she's a black woman and she's a liberal.
Really?
A woman does not belong on a... on the as a judge, to be a judge, because a woman is not justice minded. She is more like mercy minded, mercy for the wrong people.
Okay.
Yeah.
She's a black woman.
Yeah. And a black woman.
And why do you feel that way?
I know that way. Why do I know that way?
I don't know why you feel that way.
Because look at her. She was an Obama judge. That's disgusting.
And? But you're still not telling me why you feel that way. Not Obama judge, because she's not. Obama was denied a judge, so she can't be his judge if he was a bad one.
What?
So now
he was denied a judge?
Yes, that's right. He was denied a judge.
No, he was denied a Supreme Court justice.
A justice field judge.
One, but he got two females. He got two female Supreme Court justices. I feel bad pointing those two fingers.
Ms. McConnell denied, and he admitted that he did. So now, what's your problem with this lady that they have now?
That has nothing to do with this woman.
She did not do.
That's an Obama judge. She's an Obama
judge. She don't have a pass when she tried to do anything to men.
Oh, yes, she did. Oh, yes, she does.
She don't have nobody accusing
her. Oh, yes, she does.
Who? What? Tell me. I don't know. I understand.
Oh, you don't know? You haven't been paying attention to my show, and I can't remember. What's this woman? What's this woman's name again? Ketanji. Ketanji Jackson. Okay.
And why does she have the name?
All right, so,
what does her name mean?
Hold on. During her time on, this is what she did to men. During her time on the district court, Jackson wrote multiple decisions adverse to the positions of the Trump administration. In her opinion, ordering Trump's former White House counsel, Don McGahn, to comply with a legislative subpoena, she wrote, presidents are not kings. So she hates Trump. She handed a number of challenges to the executive agency actions that raised questions of administrative law. She also issued rulings in several cases that gained particular political attention. She was a political person. She said that Trump's executive orders conflicted with federal employees' rights to collective bargaining, meaning she was a union communist woman. And I think that she had something to do with the border. Let me see. American Federation of Government Employees, AFL-CIO versus Trump. She invalidated provisions. She was pro-union, invalidated provisions of three executive orders that would have limited the time federal employees, labor union officials, could spend with union members. She also did an injunction against Trump, I believe, that would have suspended expedited removal, fast-track deportations without immigration court hearings for undocumented immigrants, meaning illegal aliens. And I think that one was overturned. She issued a preliminary injunction, and that was overturned. Nice. Yeah, a D.C. court reversed her preliminary injunction. Ridiculous. So, yeah, she hates men. She hates Trump. She has a history of being against men.
And that's why you feel that way.
If she's an Obama judge, she hates men, because Obama hates men.
You need to stop. You're funny. You need to stop. That's why
I don't need to stop. I don't need to do anything but stay white and live.
When I say, that's right, you stay white and live, that's why I don't stay black and live. We both can do the same thing.
No, that's not the line. No, that's not what the blacks say.
No.
Are you black?
You don't know anything about black people.
I didn't know plenty about blacks. Give me a break.
You don't even like your brother's wife from the way you sound. You say she's a Hispanic. You don't like her. You don't like nothing about
her. I never said my brother's wife is a Hispanic.
You did so.
I did not.
Yes, you did.
No, I did not.
Okay, well, I guess you just run in your mouth like you do every day. But as I was saying...
You got it backwards.
No.
Maze, are you black?
Excuse me?
Are you black?
No.
That's
not what my birth certificate... I go by what my birth certificate say.
Are you Negroid?
I put that up. So now why do it matter?
What did you say?
I'm a human being that was put here by
God. What does your birth certificate say?
All his got a role. What?
What does your birth certificate say?
It says colored.
Oh, you're colored.
Whatever that represents.
Did you know what this colored people say? The line that the colored people say is not going to stay black and live. And you said stay black and live, right?
That's what I said.
Yeah. But no, the blacks say, I don't got to do nothing but stay black and die.
Really?
Yeah, that's what they say.
You're not around black people. You just repeat.
Yeah, no, I am around black people. You're lying.
No, you're not.
Yeah.
Tell me how many.
Too many.
Oh, you're right. And you fool somebody with that. But I'm saying, you teach the hate, because I asked you, what did you think about this lady becoming a judge? You gave me everybody else's reason to shut yours. And you sitting up here spewing hate out to somebody else.
How do you know that it's mine? How do you know that it's anything but mine?
I asked you for your opinion. I didn't ask you about nobody else's. I asked you about James' opinion.
I gave my opinion.
You gave me somebody else's opinion.
No, I didn't.
Your opinion.
No, I didn't.
It's like, I understood
whose opinion did I give?
I'm gonna understand you. I'm gonna tell you something. I understood what Trump said. He said he liked his poor and uneducated people. And when he said that, that's all we hear every day when we listen to people coming out poor and uneducated.
Huh?
Do you like them too? Or are you one of them?
One of who?
Because if you're not educated, you're walking around here being a fool for somebody else, repeating what they gotta say.
What do you mean by educated?
So you find your way, and it's all not all about Caucasians. CWPs, it's not all about you. God put everybody down here. All God's children got a role. You know that? Did you know that? Every one of us that he put down here gave us breath has a role. You can't take the breath away, and I can't take it away. And you know when storms come about.
You think a woman should be a judge?
Yes. A woman should be anything she want to be, except a man.
You know, it's so disgusting.
That's what I think.
There's this female so-called justice who's dead now. The notorious RBG, Ruth Bader Ginsburg, who said, when will there be enough female judges on the court? When it's half, or it's more than half, right? She'll be like, no, when it's all women judges, that justices on the Supreme Court, that's when it'll be enough. That's when equality will be enough.
Isn't that
so clever and evil? Because she's sour grapes. Maze, be quiet while I'm talking. She's sour grapes because men have dominated where they belong, and women are now, she wants women to dominate where they don't belong.
Oh, really?
Or she's dead now. She doesn't want that anymore. She probably wants ice water.
Who's to tell people where they belong, James? That's what I'm trying to hit. You want to tell everybody where they belong except you.
You think women belong on the Supreme Court? I think they don't. You have an opinion on where they belong, right?
Anywhere they want to be. I said women belong anywhere they want to be except being a man. Mm. Just like a man should be anywhere he want to be except trying to be a woman. That's how I say that.
No, you're wrong about that.
But if you
because that's what they're trying to do. That's what the that's what this woman is trying to do. Be a man. She's trying to play
no,
man.
No, who said so?
God said so.
Well, did they have angels in heaven? Were
yes.
they all men?
The angels are neither male nor female. I don't know what the
yeah,
angels
yeah.
are.
Yeah, and you're talking about hell is on hell. Always been out here on earth.
Yeah.
The people think they're gonna leave. They go in hell. They already in hell because they hellified themselves.
Your
and
girlfriend.
They take hate.
Your girlfriend is asking that I ask you for your personal number so we can do wellness checks every now and then.
I don't need my personal number because I'm only wellness check that I need is my family to check on me. I don't need y'all to check on me.
Okay.
Because y'all do vicious stuff.
I respect. Oh, well, we
but
would not do that.
My phone number.
Well, I'm not asking for it publicly. I would never dox you, Mace. We're not like that.
I don't have a girlfriend. What girlfriend?
I didn't say anything like that. I said I would never dox you.
No, you saying a wellness check. Why you need a wellness check on me?
Your girlfriend cares about you. You're her favorite caller.
What girlfriend?
Oh, not your girlfriend. I'm talking about your girlfriend in the chat.
I'm wondering, like, what are you talking about?
I'm not talking about your girlfriend. I'm
so
talking
being
about
being a smart person.
Our your being girlfriend.
Being a smart person, if I don't call this show and something's wrong with me, I have a number to somebody to call your show and tell you there's something wrong with me.
Oh, that's kind. I appreciate
that,
Mace.
That's good enough. That's using your brain. And
yeah,
not your,
brain power.
Yeah. I use what's
apparently
behind my
Earl
ass.
Didn't have such brain power.
Well. So that's just the way that goes. So don't worry about me. I said I'm not looking for people to like me.
Okay.
I don't care if they like me or not.
All right. Well, thank you, Mace.
I'm not
appreciate
for that.
It.
So when you're spreading hate, somebody leave and let you know what you're doing.
Yeah.
Find out, just like I say, if you hate something, know why you hate it. Don't go through somebody else and do it.
Okay.
And like that mess that was on there yesterday, talking about the one that was on, what's his name? Not Donnie Armour, but that other one. What's his name?
Asmodor?
Asmodor. Asmodor is messed up. He's worse than a donkey.
Wow.
Messed
okay,
up in
Mace.
The head.
Gotta go.
And you agree with him.
Of course.
Like I say, Trump say he like he's poor and uneducated.
You have a good
Think
day.
About it. You have one too.
All right. Bye. Interesting call. 10 minutes with my favorite caller, Maze. Donning Armour in California. Thank you for holding. What's up?
Man, I wanted to talk to her.
Oh, you know, that crossed my mind. It crossed my mind, but apologies.
I was specifically calling to ask if she identifies as a person of color.
Right.
What is, what group of people are not a person of color?
I know.
I would love to find out because it sounds like she hates white people. She's an anti-white pig.
Right? Oh, man, that's cold. You threw a pig in there. She is anti-white. She does hate it any time a white calls in and tells the truth.
Mays, call back in and
No.
Name
I'm the
one
host.
Group of people that is not a person of color.
Well, she did say...
When you think person of color, you're excluding one group of people.
I have to disagree with you slightly here. She said she's colored because that's what her birth certificate says. So...
But who's not colored?
I know. But she leans on
name
the...
Name it.
Birth
say it.
Birth
certificate. Right now.
Nobody's not colored. We're all white colored. But,
no, I'm talking to Maze.
Yeah,
I have to talk to Maze through you.
Yeah.
So which group of people are not colored? She's talking about an entire group of people except for one. What is the one race that she's not referring to?
Yeah. You know, I think back in the day, honestly,
white people.
Colored used to mean just black. Actually, in South Africa, it meant mixed. But in America, color just meant black. It didn't mean that you were, I don't think that it meant that you could be Asian or Hispanic or Muslim, Arab or whatever. It
She's
used to just mean black.
She's a disgusting anti-white pig.
Yeah.
She's a disgusting anti-white pig.
I know. But yeah.
When you say people of color, you are excluding one group of people.
Yep.
That's white people.
Yep.
We need to realize this. We need to come to grips with it.
I know. I'm aware of that.
She discriminates against white people. She hates white people. She's an anti-white piece of filth.
Well, keep it easy, man. Don't let her get to you. A lot of people hate Maze.
I don't hate her. I just think that she's an anti-white pig.
Okay. Well, thank you, Donning Armour. I appreciate it, man. It is true.
All right, man. Have a good one.
All right. You as well. It is a fact that when they say people of color, they're pitting everybody against whites. And those people don't love one another. It's ridiculous. I got some super chats. Danimal says, Hake, when's your next debate? Hake is on... And I presume that it means fire, because Fresh Prince did the same thing. But for some reason, Streamlabs does not show the emojis. But it says, Hake is on... And it leaves me hanging. But presumably it means... that means fire. Well, I actually do have a next debate, and it has been announced. Let me go to twitter.com/thehakereport, go to my likes. I think it's in my likes, and I shall retweet this. The Crucible. I'm going on The Crucible again against Everyday Bastiat. Bastiat. Bastiat is a liberal guy on Twitch. Going to debate about individual freedom. This guy is for total individual freedom, which I presume to mean that he's for abortion, so-called abortion, for the women, not for the men. The men don't have any say. He's probably for the pot and the pornography and all kinds of same-sex so-called marriage and probably all kinds of degenerate things. I shall look into it and explore in this upcoming debate. Going live the 24th, which is March 24th, is Thursday, 2022 AD, at 6 p.m. Pacific Daylight Time. He put PST, Pacific Standard Time, but it's Pacific Daylight Time. 6 Pacific, 8 Central, 9 Eastern, this Thursday. It'll be on twitch.tv/T_Crucible. On The Crucible. It should hopefully also be on YouTube. He said, oh, it's not about race, so it won't be TOS. Because he's been, the Crucible people have been censoring the YouTube videos in which I appear frequently when I've been on their show. Because they want to protect their channel. Understandable. And so we have to show it to you guys on Odyssey and other platforms. But, yeah, so that's, I will put that up on the website. On the, thehakereport.com/appearances, okay? Asmodor with the super chat states, colored was the accepted legal term for blacks in the mid-20th century. So the early, mid-1900s, like 1950s, they were called colored. WWB advocate says, Hake, this caller is right. The term color or colored and any variation is excluding Westmen. It's anti-white. Well, especially when they go people of color, which is everybody who's not white. But yeah, Maze was going by the birth certificate, which was the white man calling her colored. And it was accepted. Your girlfriend with a super chat over there on Odyssey, odyssee.com/@thehakereport. Who does Donning Armor think he is trying to ruin a perfectly good Maze call? Well, thank you, your girlfriend. I appreciate that. We had Maze confused. She's all, I don't have a girlfriend. Or what? You don't know my female friends, right? Basically, something like that. Anyway, I appreciate all the super chats, guys. Nice to hear from you. Shout out to the... live chat callers. I cannot get to you, Andres, and the rest of the callers. Have to catch me tomorrow. Hopefully I'll be live again. TheHakereport.com. Thank you, and take care.